Hare Krishna Prabhus, please accept my humble obeisances, all this is your prophet. Welcome devotees to our morning Bhagavatam class. This morning we will be discussing on Srimad-Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 8, Verse 50, towards the end of the chapter entitled Prayers by Quintin Parikshit Sev, when we are so fortunate and blessed that we could have His Holiness Candramauli Swami with us. Hare Krishna Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances, all this is your prophet.
Hari Om, Anasuya.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Nice to see you and hear you.
You too, Maharaj. As always. Maharaj, we're still waiting for more devotees to roll in. I just texted Srimati. I don't know if they got the alert, but you can go with the class.
Yeah, let's see if they roll out and roll in.
I'm hoping they will roll in, Maharaj.
Roll out of bed and roll into the class.
That's a good one, Maharaj.
Okay, so we start?
Yes, Maharaj, please go ahead, Maharaj. If you want to make it a little longer opening so others can roll out and roll in.
It's a rolling program here. Okay, rolling. Okay, we'll start and I'll give a longer introduction to the whole thing.
No problem, Maharaj.
Okay, lunch is at 2:15. Yeah. And make sure she brings some lemon. Okay, so. Om Gyan Timidandasya Gina Jana Salakaya Chaksun Malitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Maum Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutalai Shri Makti Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tinamine. Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pacharine Nirvisesa Sunyavadi Pastyatya Deye Sitar Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavam Shcha Shri Rupam Sarvijatam Sahaganat Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Sarvadutam Purijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakam Vitamscha Hey Krishna Kuru Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radhikanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gaurangira Hey Vrindavani Suri Vrishavana Suti Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Panchakalpa Tarubhischa Kripa Sindhu Vedicha Patitanam Pavane Gyo Vaishnave Gyo Namaha 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 Ajanu Lambita Bhujo Kanaka Madato Sankirtanai Papitaro Kamalaya Takso Vishwambaro Dwijabaro Yudhidharma Balo Vande Jagatvi Akaro Kuruma Epataro Vande Shri Krishna Chaitanya Nityanando Sano Dino Guru Daya Pushpanvanta Chitta Sando Tino Rupta Rupa Sarupa Kam Bhakti Avatar Bhakti Kyam Namami Bhakti Shakti Kam Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Vore Bhakti Vrindam Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Does my
screen look bigger to you than normal? Yes, Maharaj, it actually does look a bit bigger, yes.
Significantly?
I wouldn't say significantly, but definitely a little bit bigger.
Okay, I got a monitor now, so I don't know how to use it to make it look bigger, but let's see.
I could tell that it was a monitor because of the way you were looking. I said, it must be on the wall somewhere.
Yeah, it's right above the computer.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, Okay.
But actually, Maharaj, it shows more of you. I have to say that. Like, it shows more of you than it used to be before.
Okay. Yeah. If you know any other tricks on how to increase the size more, just mention it, because I don't know much about these things.
I will ask my girls and one of our youth, Maharaj. They are pretty good at this kind of stuff.
Okay.
Definitely, Maharaj.
Okay, we'll begin. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Srimad-Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 8, verse number 50. Naino Rajan Prajabhartur Dharma Yudhyan Vadodisham Itimena Tu Buddhaya Kalpate Shashanam Bachaha. Translation. Now, this is King Yudhisthira speaking. There is no sin for a king who kills for the right cause, who is engaged in maintaining his citizens, but this injunction is not applicable to me. Purport. Maharaj Yudhisthira thought that although he was not actually involved in the administration of the kingdom, which was being carried on well by Duryodhana without harm to the citizens, he caused the killing of so many living beings only for his personal gain of the kingdom from the hands of Duryodhana. The killing was committed not in the course of administration, but for the sake of self-aggrandizement, and as such he taught himself responsible for all the sins. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. So King Yudhisthira is lamenting that so many persons had to die, soldiers, so many women had to become widows, so many children had to become without fathers, and so many sisters became without brothers because of him. But he is not seeing the whole picture, or you might say, he's just acting according to what he feels is the whole reason why the fight was begun to put him on the throne. But actually it was more than that. The fact that he was chosen to be the king was because he was a devotee, he was righteous, and he represented Dharma. Where Duryodhana was the opposite. He was avaricious. He was very much self-indulgent, and he wanted the throne for his own, you know, benefit. He represented irreligion. We have the example how the battle actually was the last resort, and not something that was entered into immediately. Krishna, when the Pandavas were the rightful heirs to the throne, actually it was Dhritarashtra who was thinking that I was supposed to be the king. My brother Pandu had died, and therefore I was supposed to be the king. But because I am blind, I wasn't able to take the throne, and therefore it should have went to my sons. But actually the sons of Pandu were the actual heir and not Dhritarashtra's sons. So based on Dhritarashtra's own selfish interest, thinking that, well, I can't become the king, so at least my sons should have it. So he used his political position and was able to establish his own son, Duryodhana, on the throne. But then that was illegal. And there was some contention because the Pandavas were actually the rightful heirs to the throne. And Krishna, being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, was personally present, and he tried to arbitrate in such a way as that even it seems like Krishna took a compromised position. At one time, he went to see Duryodhana and explaining that, you know, all right, you want to rule, but the Pandavas, they are Kshatriyas. They also have to rule. That is their dharma. So give them some land, 5 villages. Each one can rule 5 villages. But Duryodhana was so greedy, so narrow-minded in his greed, that he simply said, I will not give them even enough land to put a head of a pin on. Krishna came to arbitrate on behalf of the Pandavas, and he became angry at Krishna for making that proposal, and then he called his soldiers to arrest Krishna. But Krishna responded by showing his universal form, and all of the soldiers went flying in different directions. Even Duryodhana saw the universal form, but still he maintained his position of being the ruler, despite that here was the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna himself, requesting. We see that even today, that people know what God wants and they know what is right, but they can't do it or they won't do it. This time you might even say, even in Krishna consciousness, when we are practicing devotional service, we know there's certain things that we should be doing, or maybe even things we should be avoiding. And we know this is the will of Krishna, and we know it's for our own benefit, but still we can't do it. That is called Hridaya Dulabhya. Hridaya Dulabhya means weakness of heart, knowing what is right and still unable to carry it out. Dhritarashtra was an example of that to the fullest extent. He knew his sons were not, they were kind of avaricious. Duryodhana was the head, and he had Dushasana, and he had 98 other sons. He had 100 sons. He knew that they were not righteous, but still, because of his attachment for them in the on the skin level, the family level, he still supported them. And he even said that. And he even admitted he couldn't go against his desire for having his sons as the rulers of the world. So when Krishna realized there was no other way, then war became inevitable. And this was the greatest war in the history of wars. More than 640 million soldiers were killed, and hardly anyone escaped that war. I think there are only 7 people, the 5 Pandavas, and a few of the Kurus escaped the war, such as Kripacharya was one, and who else? Duryodhana also, he wasn't killed in the battle. And Bhishma Dev wasn't killed. I think it was a handful of soldiers. I think aside from the Pandava, there were 7 persons on the other side that were still remaining. But it was such a toll. And interesting to note, just as a side point, that the only ones that died in that war were the soldiers. There were no innocent civilians killed. There were no women, no children, and no one that was other than those who actually fought were actually killed. And the reason for that was the righteousness of the Kshatriya Dharma, where you fight against the enemy and the enemy fights against you. You don't fight against someone who is not fighting against you. Nowadays, we see wars. People are just demons. They don't care. They'll go and throw a bomb into a marketplace and blow up children and innocent people and call that some kind of, you know, attack. They call it, don't really call it, terrorists. They just kill wantonly. And it doesn't even matter. They killed citizens, they killed, it doesn't, animals, everything. So today, nobody has any understanding of righteousness when it comes to war, because nobody's righteous. And so nowadays, everyone is in danger during a war. It doesn't matter. They throw bombs on hospitals and other places also. And just like at the end of World War II, the Japanese had already officially surrendered, but not formally. And the war apparently was over. The Japanese were defeated, but the United States wanted to test that bomb that they had, the atomic bomb. So even though it was officially over, they dropped that bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki and killed hundreds and thousands of people with that bomb. Mostly, you know, innocent people who are just citizens of Japan. And it's mentioned that the pilots who were driving those planes later on went insane. There were two pilots on that plane, and both of them went insane. They had unnecessarily killed hundreds and thousands of people. The war was officially over. So nowadays, war is just barbaric. There's no reason for it, and there's no way. People are cowards. They hide behind, you know, these various types of weaponry. But here you see face-to-face warfare, and they also had powerful weapons. Of course, you did have one example where, in the previous chapter we just finished, you had Asvatthama, when he illegally killed the five sleeping sons of Draupadi. And he was thinking that would please Duryodhana. But although Duryodhana was so cruel and vicious, when Asvatthama came and brought the heads of the dead sons to Duryodhana was not at all pleased with Asvatthama. He was not at all pleased. So Duryodhana had some finesse. Also, Prabhupada said, people make a lot of negative propaganda against Hitler. And Hitler was quite vicious. He unnecessarily killed millions of Jewish people and others. But when it came to dropping the bomb, he had the bomb. Actually, the bomb was created in Germany by, what was his name? I can't remember. Actually, it was created in the United States and then brought to Germany. And Germany had the bomb, but Hitler could have used it against the Europeans, the Russians, and the British, but he didn't. And Prabhupada said he had what is called a human concern. He knew that this bomb would kill thousands and thousands of innocent people. So Prabhupada said Hitler had some decency. People don't like to hear that, but that was one consideration. He did have the bomb, but didn't drop it. But here you see, back to the text itself, how Yudhisthira, there was nothing wrong with Yudhisthira taking the throne because it was Krishna's desire. It was Dharma Yudhya. Yudhya means to fight, and Dharma means on behalf of religious principles. So this fight was based on religious principles, and therefore it's righteous. And Prabhupada said this was the last religious war in the history of wars. Now people fight wars over oil rights, or national interests, or hatred for another ethnic group or country. There's no reasons for wars nowadays except just hatred, greed, lust, anger. Here there was a principle. The principle was that Krishna wanted the Pandavas to rule the world because they were devotees. He wanted righteous rule, and he got his way. And Yudhisthira was meant to be on the throne. But Yudhisthira is the soft-hearted king who sees that just because of me being placed on the throne, so many soldiers had to die. So he's lamenting. His lamentation continues and for a few more of the verses, and you'll see how Krishna solves the problem to help him understand his situation. And then he rightfully takes the throne, and then he performs the Rajasuya sacrifice, which was a tremendous sacrifice. It's not easy to perform Rajasuya sacrifice. You need immense amounts of wealth, and all the treasuries of both sides had been exhausted because of the war. So there wasn't any wealth to carry on the Rajasuya sacrifice. And then Krishna instructed the Pandavas to go to different places and find gold. There was a gold mountain that was left by one king. He didn't want it. It was full of gold. So they went there and other places to retrieve gold. And then the Rajasuya sacrifice was performed to declare to the world that Yudhisthira was now the king and he was the rightful king. But King Yudhisthira performed that yajna not only because it was necessary to establish his rule in the world, but to glorify Lord Sri Krishna. And so you'll see during that Rajasuya sacrifice, the best man is always elected to be honored. And Krishna was the best man during that time. Of course, there was a little opposition to Krishna being chosen because many of the kings around the world had come for the Rajasuya sacrifice, and one king was King Shishupal, who hated Krishna with a passion. And he protested when Krishna was actually chosen. And he was just criticizing Krishna and explaining in different ways why Krishna was not qualified to be on the throne. And he's not even a Kshatriya, he's a Vaishya. He's born in a cowherd family. And so many reasons that he found that Krishna was, he was a coward because he left the battlefield when he was fighting with Jarasandha at one point. So many poor reasons. Now the tension was building up in during the sacrifice, right in the arena. And Krishna knew that there was going to be a battle between those who sided with Shishupal and those who sided with Yudhisthira's choice. So in order to avert the whole sacrifice being contaminated and desecrated, destroyed, because if there was a battle there, that would have ruined the whole sacrifice and everything would have been lost. So Krishna took out his Sudarshan chakra and immediately cut off the head of Shishupal. Of course, that was one reason. The other reason was Shishupal was one of the last in the manifestations of Jaya and Vijaya, and so he was meant to be killed by the Lord so he could retain his position back in the spiritual world as the gatekeepers, Jaya and Vijaya. Of course, after Shishupal was killed and Dantavarka, who was the other person, was killed by Krishna, that was a big fight, because when Dantavarka heard that his good friend Shishupal was killed, he was a king also, so he stationed himself right at Mathura. And Krishna, he was afraid, Krishna was afraid he was going to attack Mathura and kill his family members, the residents of Vrindavan. But Krishna rushed immediately, and there was a battle for one full evening, and then Krishna killed Dantravarka. So Dantravarka and Shishupal were the last manifestation in the Jaya and Vijaya, who had cursed to fall to the material world as demons in order to battle with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And so, but in that Rajasuya sacrifice, Krishna could have killed Shishupal in another way, but he chose that particular time because he didn't want that sacrifice to be desecrated. And making look King Yudhisthira's whole proposal to be destroyed. So that was a little bit about that. So it wasn't easy establishing Yudhisthira on the throne. Even though Krishna was personally present, it was very difficult. Big war had to be fought, and then so much political intrigue, and so many things happened even after the battle of Kurukshetra. And now you see King Yudhisthira, he's lamenting. But his lamentation is an indication of his soft-heartedness, because as he says here, only those who kill for the right cause, but that doesn't apply to me. So he was feeling unhappy because so many apparently innocent persons were killed because of him being established on the throne. But the larger picture was, of course, that his soft-heartedness was a indication of his quality of a Vaishnava. A Vaishnava is by nature soft-hearted. Like that. And you see, Arjuna was also like that at the beginning, when Krishna wanted him to fight at the very beginning. And he also gave reasons why killing the soldiers on the other side would result in so many unnecessary deaths. And we cannot accept the throne because these persons that we have to kill, they are dear to us. So how can we enjoy that throne? Because they are very dear to us. They are family members, friends, and teachers, so many close relationships that Arjuna had. So both him and Yudhisthira seem to have that same expression, that when they were asked to fight and kill and accept the benefits of that, both of them were lamenting because they felt that this was not necessary. But Krishna had a plan, and Krishna's plan was yada yada yadharmasya glanir bhavati bharata mabhuta namma dharmasya tadatmaham srijami aham Paritya Sarunam Dhanasanaya Chidus become Dharma Samstarpanartaya Sambhavami Yuge Yuge Pravitranayam Sarunam Dhanasanaya Chaduskritam. To Chaduskritam, the Duskritams, the miscreants who cause havoc to the world, who rule and for their own vested interest. Just like we have now, we have the world ruled by a whole gang of Duskritams who don't care about the citizens. All they do is care about exploiting the citizens and getting as much money and power as they can. So when devotees ask, well, what is Krishna going to come? Prabhupada said, yes, Krishna has already come in the form of his holy name, Kali Kale Nama Rupa Krishna Avatar. Nama hoite haya sarva jagat nishchara. That Krishna is incarnated in his holy name. He's also incarnated in the deity. He's also, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also came in this age. They all came to purify the age by spreading the chanting of the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra all everywhere. So Lord Chaitanya has predicted that in due course of time, Krishna consciousness will spread throughout the world and it will become the religion of the world. In other words, people will become righteous. People will become Krishna conscious or God conscious. We can include that also. So there is a war going on right now. The war to save the souls from falling into the pitfall of materialistic society, which is just gobbling up people's good qualities in so many different ways. We see that now, without going into the present political situation, which I don't think is necessary for this particular class. Everyone can understand that we are battling against irreligion just to stay Krishna conscious. As Srila Prabhupada said, we have no problems with Maya. Maya is our friend. She works to help the devotees become Krishna conscious. But because there are so many demons, Maya has to serve the demons. And so she's serving the demons and the demons are becoming powerful. And because that is their food, they've taken over the political industry, they've taken over the entertainment industry, they've taken over the social amenities that govern society, they've taken over the medical industry, they've taken over, even in some areas, religious positions. And the demons are everywhere in the world today. Their whole program is to make the world, you know, irreligious and subjugate all the people. And as Prabhupada said, as time goes on, you know, more and more people will be subjected to the harassment of the demons. And at one point he said, these cities that we live in, they will no longer be livable. They'll be just dens of thieves and various other kinds of crimes. Prabhupada said, our movement will only survive if we make these farm communities develop self-sufficient, develop Daivi Van Ashram, spiritual Van Ashram. That will bring about a foundation for the spreading of Krishna consciousness throughout the world. Prabhupada said the devotees can preach in the cities and live on the farms. And he said the preaching will go on. The cities will still have our preaching centers, but for our livelihood will depend on Krishna, as Krishna lived, simple living, high thinking. Krishna is the farmacharya. Krishna carries a flute, a bugle, and a walking stick. And Balaram carries the club and the plow, and for plow means, and of course, that's very much connected with agriculture. But it also means Balaram plows the heart and makes the heart fertile for the present of Krishna consciousness. And Krishna comes and plays his flute, and then the living entities are attracted back to him in loving devotional service. Mm-hmm. So the Supreme Personality of Godhead has a plan to purify the whole world. And it will happen, but as Prabhupada said, if you don't do it, the next generation will do it. And if they don't do it, the next generation will do it. So let's do it. Let's spread the holy name everywhere and anywhere and get people to chant Hare Krishna, especially in today's particular situation. And the preaching is really good. Right now we're in the middle of the Christmas marathon. Distribute books and distribute Harinams everywhere. In this way, the world will have a chance to pull itself out from this tyrannical rules that are going on in the name of economic development. Okay, so King Yudhisthira is showing to us what is the quality of a righteous ruler. He's concerned about the welfare of everyone. He's not just interested in his power, his position, and a few of his followers. He is actually God conscious, and those who are God conscious, they work for the benefit of everyone.
Thank you so much, Maharaj, for such a wonderful class. Really, really nice. A lot of points, and I want to ask devotees if there are any questions, any clarification. Can you please do unmute yourself and jump right in? Or you can raise your hand. Either is fine. Just going down the list to see if there are any questions. Let me see.
I have a request.
Yes, Maharaj, please.
We go back to the original site and ask the devotees to turn on their videos, because for questions and answers, it's very nice to see the audience and
I agree, Maharaj. Completely agree. If anyone has a question, please do turn on your videos so Maharaj can see all of that. And plus, it's more personal. It's definitely more personal than saying black box.
Bring back the original screen too.
Yeah. Sure, Maharaj. Meaning you want me to stop sharing the screen, Maharaj? I can do that now.
I want to get to gallery so I can see all
got
the
it. Videos. Yeah. There we go. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So if anyone has a question, please do unmute yourself or jump right in and ask a question. Maharaj, I have a question while others are thinking. Maharaj, you said you explained the term weakness of heart, knowing what's right, but still unable to carry it out. How can we as devotees, Maharaj, really identify that we have a weakness in heart? Like, how
is it? Not everybody does, but there are those who have that. Like, we have the four regulative principles. So sometimes we think, well, you know, why not 3.5? Or, you know, I can't do it. I want to be a devotee. I can't do it. You can still practice Krishna consciousness if you're not up to the standard. But the idea is to practice where you actually come to the standard. What are some of the other things? What would be an example for that? I can think of the four regulative principles. And, you know, now marijuana is legal in many of the states in the United States now. So, you know, let me smoke a little pot and chant a little Hare Krishna. And, you know, I get a higher consciousness and I get more realizations. Yeah, I mean, Prabhupada was approached with that by a very famous champion of the younger generation during that time, who was talking about that. You know, why not, you know, smoke marijuana and chant Hare Krishna? That's what he was doing. Prabhupada said, no, that's artificial dependence. We have to be dependent on Krishna, not something artificial. And that's one of the principles, no intoxication, no illicit sex, no meat eating, and no gambling. These are foundational.
Maharaj, to piggyback on that question, Maharaj, sometimes we have come across situations where a person knows, I'm trying to think of how to say this, like, and going back to the verse that you were speaking on, that King Yudhishthira was lamenting because of so many souls being killed, so many soldiers, but he was not doing it for attachment to the property or land or whatever's, you know, for righteousness. And sometimes when we want to do something in Krishna consciousness, you know, we've come across situations where devotees use Krishna's name in vain, lack of better word. Oh, but it's Krishna's service. Or, and when it's not the right thing to do, and I'm assuming that might fall under weakness of heart, how can we use our discretion, Maharaj, and not say, oh, it's Krishna's mercy, oh, it's Krishna's service, you know, like very loosely?
Well, there's a story related to that when the devotees were, Prabhupada had left 26 Second Avenue to open up his centers in Los Angeles and San Francisco. So the devotees in New York were still trying to get a new building. So they had met this Mr. Price. Mr. Price liked the devotees, apparently, and he had presented this building. But he made it sound like the devotees had to bid on it in order to get it. So they did. And then Prabhupada had already instructed devotees, don't give any money until the contract is signed. He gave them an instructions, don't give any money until that contract is signed. Mr. Price came up with an idea that, well, there's another buyer, but I want you guys to have it. And so if you give me $5,000 down payment, then I can hold the building for you. And then eventually, when the deal is settled, then you'll have the building. So they had already heard Srila Prabhupada's instructions, but they went ahead and went with Mr. Price's offer to give $5,000 ahead of the final agreement. They called Prabhupada right after they did it in San Francisco, and Prabhupada said, stop payment on that check immediately. So they went to the bank to stop the payment, but the check had already been cashed. They went to the Mr. Price's office, and his office was cleaned out. He was gone. He had stolen the $5,000. They called Srila Prabhupada and told him, and they said, and then they said, Prabhupada, this is what happened. Prabhupada said, and they said, it was Krishna's mercy. And Prabhupada said, it was your stupidity. It wasn't Krishna's mercy. And then the next thing they heard was click. The phone, Prabhupada put the phone down. So they had lost that $5,000. Prabhupada came back to New York right after that and somehow or other did some work and was able to retrieve $2,000 of it back. But they had lost, they had made Prabhupada do all that, and they had lost $3,000. So you make a mistake and you say it's Krishna's mercy, but no. If you have an instruction and you don't follow it, you can't use that Krishna's mercy. It doesn't apply. The instruction is Krishna's mercy, not what happens. Now, if you don't have an instruction, then you should get one to get a clarification if there's some concern about whether this activity is in line with Krishna consciousness or not. But if you're insincere, you won't do that. You won't consult with others, especially those who are in a position to give advice, then you'll go ahead and do it. And then the results may not be, maybe, you know, disasters.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Maharaj.
Can we get the rest of the devotees to turn on their cameras? Or
yes. Yeah, we got 19 devotees here. If they could turn on their cameras, that would be great. One by one, coming up, Maharaj. Any other questions from devotees? Please do jump right in and ask.
Okay.
I don't want to be the only one asking. It would be nice if others can ask any questions, any clarification. Any points? I can ask another question if others want to think. Maharaji, if you could clarify this point that you made. You said that Maya is our friend, so she's helping us to become more Krishna conscious. And then you said that Maya is helping the demons. Can you clarify that point, Maharaj? Because Maya is Krishna's agent.
It's a statement by Prabhupada. Prabhupada said, we have no problem with Maya. She's our friend, but because there are demons, she must serve them. Therefore, all the problems in the world are now due to demons. It's not problem. It's not hard to become Krishna conscious. It's easy. But the demons are making everybody. It's just the way they do the whole social, political, everything, economic system is controlled by the demons. And it's therefore it becomes so hard to become Krishna. You know, you really have to struggle against their programs. Demons are afraid of religion, and the demons won't squash religion right out because they know if they try to do that, there'll be a strong backlash. So what they'll do is they'll try to squash the people first, and then once the people are squashed, then they'll squash religions when there's no support left. So that's their program. The demons are very, very materially intelligent. Super intelligent. They know how to manipulate material energy. They actually worship Maya. They worship Maya, and they get the intelligence how to manipulate the material energy. Demons are very, very materially intelligent. But Krishna is more intelligent than everybody. So if we take shelter of Krishna and take shelter of Krishna's pure representatives, especially Srila Prabhupada, the demons can't do anything. And that means Hare Krishna. Chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and keep an association with devotees. And this is one of the most important things, to continue to have association with Vaishnavas. Because we get strength, we get intelligence, we get inspiration, we get our doubts cleared. And this is the most important thing. Sadhu Sangha and chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. And now distributing Krishna's mercy in the form of books and the holy name, Ushadam, whatever way we can reach the conditioned souls.
Thank you, Maharaj. Maharaj, I just got a private request for a question, but I think you addressed it, but I'm going to ask on behalf of this devotee again. This devotee is asking how to improve the weakness of the heart.
How to get rid of it.
Yeah, get rid of it, improve, strengthen, all that word.
Well, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur speaks about this in detail, and also Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Basically, they both talk about the power of the Krishna consciousness activities as the way to overcome these things. But then these things are quickly overcome through association with advanced devotees. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Sastri Hoy, Lavamatta, Sarva Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Hoy. One moment's association with a pure devotee can free one from all the reactions of all sinful activity. Faith is built in association of devotees. The faith is that principle that carries us through the various struggles in our Krishna consciousness. It destroys the doubt, and it gives clear understanding of how to proceed. But that faith is strengthened and developed in association of devotees. That's so important.
Thank you, Maharaj. Questions from devotees. I think I hit my target of 4 questions. I'm going to bore everyone else. Oh, Marcia, that's a question from Dear Krishna. He said, how to choose the right sadhu sangha?
Well, that it takes a little bit of observation. You can see. It's not necessarily always persons who are in positions, but it's persons who you can see that are those who are, that don't criticize devotees or don't find fault with others, they are good association. They are the best association, those who are free from fault finding, and those who have a taste for chanting the holy names, and those who like to serve the devotees. Those who are eager to serve the devotees, those who look for opportunities to serve the devotees. These are the persons you find, you can find, what we say, nice shelter association with. Look for that. It's not hard to find if you're looking, but if you're not looking, then it may be difficult to find.
Namrata
had a question also.
Yes, I thought I saw her hand and it went down again. Go ahead, Namrata.
No, Mataji, I think you asked that question about Maya. Why do Maya serve demons? So that was my question. You already asked it. That's why I lower my hand.
Oh, okay. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Hare Krishna. Any questions? Go ahead. Any questions from devotees? Any other questions? Please don't have to be shy. That's a perfect opportunity to ask as many questions from Candramauli Swami. I pile all my questions and wait for Marj to give class, so I just bombard it. And Marj is so patient that he answers my questions. Thank you so much, Marj. Any other questions, devotees? Such a powerful class. Marj, I want to ask one more question. And you mentioned Yudhishthira's lamentation after the war is his soft-heartedness, which is a Vaishnava quality. And one can also say, Marj, but he was a king and a leader, you know, and a manager. And how much does soft-heartedness play in leadership?
Well, here, these words that he's expressing are showing that I think there's a few other verses that indicate in more detail how he was feeling. He was feeling for the relatives of the departed soldiers. And how they will be without their protectors now. So yeah, he goes on, not just this one verse. I think there's other verses. I'm not sure either before or after this verse. It's a series of verses. Probably after, coming up maybe. Arjuna, as we mentioned, Arjuna felt the same way. But both of them were Kshatriyas, and both of them were meant to fight on religious principles, and both of them had the direction of Lord Sri Krishna, whose desire was to establish saintly rule on the throne. We quote that verse from the Bhagavad Gita that Krishna comes in certain circumstances to remove irreligion from the world. When it gets too rampant, then Krishna will make a, and so he's come, he's, as we said, he's come now in the form of the holy name. The holy name has been introduced by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as the Yuga Dharma. It's only been 535 years ago. It's not that long ago that the holy name actually was given that position. So now the holy name is it's the avatar, as we mentioned that in one verse. The holy name is non-different than Krishna in all aspects of itself. It's not like it's, you know, well, Krishna's not here. He's here personally in his holy name.
Thank you,
Mark. Those who have faith in the chanting of the holy name and take full shelter of the holy name, they are completely free from the effects of Kali Yuga, and they can also make nice progress towards pure love of God. Holy name is as powerful as Krishna is in all respects.
Thank you, Maharaj. Questions? Okay, there's one here in the chat that just popped up. Amash, this is from Vishaka. She says, Hare Krishna Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. This question is a little off the topic of discussion. Maharaj, the modern society has recognized the prevalence and importance of mental and emotional health. However, one may wonder how mental health relates to devotional life and aspiring devotees. Would it be considered one of the sufferings exclusive to this age? Is this specifically addressed and mentioned by Srila Prabhupada?
Yes, it is. Yeah. Yeah. Mental health is taken its toll. In fact, it's one of the highest forms of illness in the world, if not the highest. The registered amount of persons who are afflicted by such things is already high, but then there's the uncountable those who are not included in the tabulations. Mental health is very, very high. And it's hard to practice spiritual life if one's emotional and mental stabilities are not in line. It becomes very difficult. So, yeah. Chanting Hare Krishna is one way to keep good mental health. But the society itself is so dysfunctional that if you follow the dysfunctional society, you will become mentally ill. If you live a normal life, you're probably sick. Quote unquote normal. Now getting into the present details, you know, all you have to do is the World Health Organization out of Washington, D.C., they keep records on these things worldwide. And your Guru Maharaj was very enthusiastic to bring out statistics when he was here about that. And now the statistics have only increased in terms of proportion. And the mental illness is mostly with young people, not the older people, it's the younger people mostly.
And Maharaj, why is that so, Maharaj?
Because of the society in the last 50 years has become so destructive to mind and body, emphasizing economic development and sense gratification as the goal of life, which is contrary to the human psyche or natural. Sense gratification is needed, but in proportion to what is required, but not as the goal of life. So the highest suicide rates are amongst young people, and amongst the categories of economic development, mostly young people who are well-to-do materially, they are the highest suicide rates in the world.
Maharaj, there's a question in chat, but in follow-up on what you just said, Maharaj, we have come across, at least I have come across devotees, quote-unquote newcomers or spiritual seekers, you know, who are looking for an alternative, and when they come to the temple they like it. At the same time, they're young people, and at the same time they carry a baggage of mental health. How can we help devotees like that, who are like really seeking, you know, for something, Maharaj, and knowing that
it takes personal care? You can't just introduce them into a general way and say, okay, here's your beads and here's the books, now practice. They require someone who can actually take care of them and guide them in Krishna consciousness. Somebody who cares. And we can do that. That's our society. We can take personal interest in each and every devotee. We should do that, actually. It's always hard, because if you don't have enough caretakers, and you have a large body who needs to be taken care of, some are gonna fall through. But then again, it's up to the leaders to establish these things. So we started the devotee care system. But that system has to be developed on a very, local level. For each and every temple, each and every yatra, each and every sangha, each and every group has devotees who actually are qualified to take care and guide other devotees in their struggles to become Krishna conscious. Sometimes that takes the form of the mentor system, which is somewhat of an extension of the devotee care system. The devotee care is much more broader. It has more aspects to it than just the mentor system. You know, when a devotee gets sick, we should be concerned how to help that devotee, even if it's some physical illness or something. Prabhupada was doing that when he was here, even on an individual level, when he would see a devotee sick. Sometimes he would write a prescription on a piece of paper and give it to him, say, get this medicine, this will help you. Yeah, this was Prabhupada. There was one story where it was in Mayapur during the Guru Puja, and Prabhupada was sitting on his Vyasasan, and the Guru Puja was going on, and devotees were coming up and offering flowers. And one devotee came up and he was offering flowers, and Prabhupada noticed on his leg he had a pretty nasty cut. Prabhupada turned to him and said, "Are you taking care of that?" And the devotee didn't know what to say. And Prabhupada turned to his secretary. This is during the Guru Puja. And he said, "Give me a pencil and paper." And he did. He wrote down some medicine and he handed it to the devotee. He said, "Go to the drugstore and get this medicine." There's many other stories how Prabhupada showed individual concern to devotees' health and recommended ways that they could, get themselves, healed again. What to speak about mental health, that's also must be a feature of our society. We can't say, "Oh, that person's in Maya, and therefore let it go." No, we have to do whatever we can to help them. If we can do it, of course they also have to help themselves, but it's required.
Marge, there's a question in the chat from Nushinga Leela, and she says, "Dear Marge, please accept my humble obeisances, all glory to Srila Prabhupada. Could you please say something about the verse from Srimad-Bhagavatam 7:15-24 in connection with the topic? By good behavior and freedom from envy, one should counteract sufferings due to other living entities. By meditation in trance, one should counteract sufferings due to providence. And by practicing hatha yoga, pranayama, and so forth, one should counteract sufferings due to the body and mind. Similarly, by developing the mode of goodness, especially in regard to eating, one should conquer sleep."
An interesting verse you picked up, because the purport is really an amazing purport. So there are prescribed activities which can counteract and bring about. That whole series of verses in that section talk about counteracting various types of anomalies, and anartas also. How to counteract anger, how to counteract lust, how to counteract greed, how to counteract delusion. It's all there in that whole series of verses. So if one applies them in a regular way, then one can get the results. And Prabhupada talks about that due to animal killing, war and pestilence come, and therefore the solution for that is to chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So that verse and purport is really fundamental. We've been spreading that verse around, especially Srila Prabhupada's purport. Mm-hmm. You read the purport, it just talks to the times right now. due to wanton animal killing around the world, pestilence comes. Pestilence is a way to punish the living entities for their sinful activities. Krishna loves each and every living entity equally, no matter what body they're in. So those who unnecessarily kill other living entities for sense gratification, they're building up this horrific karma. And when countries support these kind of karmic killings, then it comes, everything starts to crumble. Some people sometimes say, well, we have economic problems and we have social problems. There's only one problem, lack of Krishna consciousness. And when morality is, when morality is replaced with gains for economic development, then you have a demoniac society. People can't even get good medical care because they don't have money. That's demoniac. Everyone should have right to medical care. Everything is based on money. So yeah, is there any particular aspect of that verse that you wanted me to focus on?
Nishingalila is going to come on now, I think. You are still on mute, Nasringali. Like, would you like to unmute yourself?
I think she's typing, right? Mm-hmm.
I'm assuming. Yeah, I'll wait for her to send her message through. She said, "Your answer is great help. Thank you." That's what she said, Mark.
Okay. Yeah, that verse is, we've been using that verse to preach Krishna consciousness in this particular situation with this worldwide epidemic.
Thank you, Marj. Any other questions from devotees? Any clarification, any follow-up on what Marj has answered? Going down the list so I don't forget anybody. If there isn't, Marj, would you like to end with one round chanting, Marj? Oh, wait, there is one. Sri Devi. Oh, wait.
Go ahead, Sri Devi. Thank you. Please accept my humble obeisances, Guru Maharaj. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to you. Thank you for elaborating on this subject matter, which is such a pressing matter of these times that we are in. I'm actually going to piggyback on Anasuya's question about how she said, today the young people who are seeking Krishna's shelter, many of them have, you know, a lot of issues, you know, mental health issues and so on. So, in fact, another temple president in America, she mentioned to me, she said, can you guys do something about this? Can ISKCON at GBC level or something address this issue? That today the young people who are coming, she told me they are just mental wrecks. She said they're coming out of PTSD or whatever it is, and they are just wrecks. She used the word wrecks. And they need extra special care, as you mentioned, and they need proper, like a multi-pronged approach to rehabilitating them, helping them to get steady in Krishna consciousness, because many of them are very unstable. So do you think that devotee care has to address this as a global issue and the GBC needs to take steps, you know, to institute devotee care, especially, you know, the mental and emotional aspects also along with physical care?
They're doing that, but maybe not. They're not doing it enough. Maybe the volume of need is greater than the amount of energy being put into it, but it's being done. We have devotees in our society who are expert, who are trained, psychologists, right? That's not a, but who know how to help devotees. So when someone comes to me, I can refer them to certain people. And I know that, you know, I mean, these people usually have a, they're always busy anyway, because they're always taking care of one after another. But it's being done within the devotee communities by devotees who are, who have degrees in these areas where they can, I don't know the exact different degrees that, that is available, but who can help? Yeah, we need to do that. We ask people to come into our temples and chant the holy names, but they can't chant because their minds are so disturbed. They try, but they can't sit down and chant. Minds too restless, too much disturbed by other things. Yeah, the more we can develop programs in this direction, the more we can, we will actually be doing a great service. So it's needed, yeah, it's needed.
And Maharaj, what I've also experienced, just piggybacking on Sri Devi's question, is even though these young people, you know, whatever age they are when they come and they carry this baggage of mental health, and like you said, Maharaj, just giving them, hey, sit and just chant the whole name is not, it's going to go away. It does not work. I mean, I've completely seen that. But I've also seen, Maharaj, that, you know, when they come to the temple looking for an alternative, they're so confused and they got so much baggage on their minds, but their heart is so sincere. I've seen that, you know, I've experienced that their heart is sincere. They're like really crying for help, you know, even though the chanting is what they struggle with. And it's like, I feel, and this is what I feel personally, and I may be wrong, I feel that, as you're mentioning, Maharaj, because of the wave that we are in right now in this Kali Yuga, there's so much mental health issues. Somehow Krishna is sending mental health, you know, people with mental health issues to the temple, you know, seeking shelter of the holy name, but at the same time seeking help with devotees to really get over their issues. Like I see that one at a time Krishna is sending, for whatever reason he's doing it, but I can see it. You know, I see it, and but their heart is like so soft, even though they're covered up with so much mental stuff. But deep down, there's some softness, Maharaj.
Well, that's there. It's well, there are places in the world who have a system in place where whatever the devotee needs, including the new people who are coming, there is a group of, you might say a little section of the group that they can be referred to. So it's financial help, emotional help, need to get married help, different things that people come in. And because Bhakti Vinod Thakur says, if one's material life is too much in turbulence, they can't practice Krishna consciousness. It becomes too hard. It becomes impossible. He makes that point. They need to settle their material situation at least to a certain degree where they can focus nicely on their Krishna. Otherwise, their material situation just pulls away their time and energy and their attention from Krishna. Mm-hmm. So you need that, yeah. We should have these, if you look to certain places in the world, I can think of one place, the devotees in Sri Sri Radha Gopinath Chaupati, they have set up all of these different categories of groups to help devotees. And they have broader categories. Everything's done on the local level, not on the guru level. The guru level is, things are, and you only come to the guru level when there's an emergency. So there's devotees taking care of devotees. Mm-hmm. That's what we should have. Because if you inspect our devotees, you'll find there's a lot of talent in our devotees. A lot of it's not even being used because it appears to be not needed, or for whatever reason, it's not being used.
Thank you, Maharaj. Any other questions from devotees? Mm-hmm. Any follow-up, any clarification? Yes, so Sumitra Mataji, you have a question? I saw you waving your hand. Mataji, you're on mute. Can you unmute yourself?
Sorry.
There you go.
Hare Krishna. Thank you for informing me. I just want to, like, you know, like politicians in parliament, they have responded what you said. So I'm not sure, do I agree with what you said at all? I mean, I like that we as a devotee can help each other, and we all need that. But at certain point, I think we have to know who is the expert. You know, when somebody is sick, and we all always, we devotees are looking like, okay, I'm alternative. I have this Reiki initiation. I have this kind of initiation. I can help, you know, fix the body. But at the end, when maybe sometimes it's earlier needed to go to the expert, you know, even we have all good intentions. And even we have, you know, Krishna is, but sometimes even it's hard for somebody to go to non-devotee doctor, because or they are ashamed to, they will have to respond, or maybe doctor will not be agree with the vegetarianism or with the philosophy if it's a mental health issue, but the expert know the right answer on time, you know, like when my children are sick, if I do a homeopathy medicine on time, the recovery goes really fast. But if I don't give a homeopathy medicine on right time, there was no use giving it to me. At the end, I have to go to the real doctor because I didn't make my move on right time. I hope I was understood by you.
Well, yeah, you're right. But we also have doctors. We have doctors. We have psychologists. We have people who are professionals who are devotees.
Yeah, of course, and I know some of them, but sometimes it happens that lots of us are getting involved. I mean, myself also. Like, okay, I'm not here to give advice. I'm here just to, like, try to help, or no, let's go to the expert. Sometimes it's hard for me to
say
I'm not an expert. I'm not a professional in this area. You have to ask somebody else.
Yeah, I agree with you. But if a devotee is trying to take care of another devotee and they can't do anything, they should refer them. Like somebody comes to me with some mental health issues, I know some devotees who work in that category and have positions there, and we can just refer them to them.
Yeah, because sometimes sorry for interrupt you, but I have experience that sometimes when some devotee comes with mental issue and we don't know that from the start, maybe some close friends knew, and they just advise them, stop taking your medicine, chanting holy name is enough. And with chanting, you will clear all your psychological problem. And then sometimes happen that during the program in temple room, just devotee starts to have this schizophrenic attack. And then we all go, and then happen to be ashamed of her or other devotees. And so, I mean, in our area, it happens something like that. So maybe that we don't take this, I mean, I know for myself, I won't suggest to anybody don't take medicine, chanting Hare Krishna is enough. Sometimes I think it's me.
There was one devotee who was just, she's not on now, but she was on earlier on today's thing. And I know her well, and she's gone through that same situation. And she had to go to professionals to get what she needed. And it worked. And now she's able to practice Krishna consciousness normally. Well, it's not that we are against, bringing people to professionals, but we shouldn't be putting ourselves in a position to try to help people if we don't have the proper qualifications. So referring, part of what I was trying to say is the devotees try to help, and if they find themselves not qualified, then they should refer that person to someone who can help them. But I like to stay within the category of devotees because I know and I have enough experience that our whole society has every occupation that the world has out there. We have everybody out there. So if I get physically sick, I can go to, I just go to, like I was sick when I was in America. Of course, I had to take help from the secular society, but was arranged through devotee doctors who were my disciples. They arranged, they couldn't do it themselves, but they arranged for me to get the care I needed. And so I got help from, because it was required that I needed some severe medical work, and I didn't know any doctors that could do it that were devotees, but they knew other doctors, so they referred to them. So I always start with the devotees in any case and see if we have within our society, and if we don't, then I agree with you 100%. We can also go to the secular society for whatever we need.
I always refer devotees to Mother Ramboru, one of the amazing mental health counselors. Like whenever I have devotees, and she's been doing it for many years. Yeah, Mother Ramboru is one of them that I always refer devotees to.
I know one lady who's really one of the best. She's in California, and I can't think of her name right now. But I refer devotees to her, and she's helped a lot. And then, of course, we have Vipula and his wife, Shamasundari. Vipula did a miracle job on one of my disciples. She was suffering from this mental illness for practically her whole life, and he cured her. He helped her. So, I mean, you just got to know where to go. That's all. Our society has them. If you don't know that they're there, then you don't go to them. Right, Ms. Ringalila? You know, right? When you find out where the help is, then you go to it. But if you don't know where it is, you don't go to it because you don't know, right?
Nice to see your camera on and seeing your beautiful face, Ms. Ringalila. Thank you.
Yeah. So she didn't have any mental health problems. I'm just, that's not, but she knows someone.
She knows someone that can help devotees. Amazing.
Yeah. She's okay. She's like 100% from the normal school.
Her smile says it all.
Yeah, but I mean, this is a constant feature of my service, is referring devotees to other devotees for help. I do it all the time.
And I know I had to do the same thing in our community too, Maharaj. There were two young men, and I referred them to Mother Ramboru, and it's helped them. They are still going through the process, but definitely they feel so good.
That's, the only problem is we don't have enough devotees doing these services. That's the problem.
Mental health is definitely one area that has to expand in ISKCON.
Like if you want help with marital problems, you just go to Sri Devi. Sri Devi has a great track record. She helps so many. She's right here. She's certified. She graduated with the diploma, and she has a long list of successes. There's so many, we have so many qualified devotees.
Like you said, Marge, it's there within our society. We just got to look for the right one and tap into it.
I wanted to set up a, what do they call it? A
directory?
I actually made an effort to set up a directory, and we did it to some degree, where you have these devotees and you have their skills. All right, Sumitra, I agree with you 100%.
Thank you, Maharaj. I mean, it's not needed to agree, but I just had, urge to say it, because we always forget. I forgot sometimes, sometimes just devotees said to me, oh, Mataji, now you get coming to advice. I was not asking you advice. So I had this, experience when.
We shouldn't try to present ourselves.
Sorry, I had just experience.
No, we shouldn't take the role of trying to be somebody's, cure agent if we can't do it. We don't have the qualifications. We should be able to see that.
There's a post in the chat from Sri Devi. I have a PhD in marriage and family therapy, and I'm a licensed marriage and family therapist. Thank you so much for sharing that, Sri Devi. Thank you.
And everybody that she's helped, everybody that she using comes out pretty good.
Thank you so much for sharing that.
And that's a big problem in today's society.
Big.
Today's Krishna Conscious Society.
It is, Maharaj. This
Kali Yuga is just, Kaler Doshan Nidhi Rajan. It's an ocean of faults. There's so many problems. It's the way it is. But the elixir or the medicine is, along with whatever else is needed, it's devotee care is one of the biggest forms of helping devotees. What does that mean? Somebody cares about me. That's important. If we don't care, we don't take time to develop that care mood, then we're just a bunch of, we haven't understood what is Krishna conscious.
Sri Devi, go right ahead. Oops, where did she go? She has a hand up.
I think that was from the previous.
Okay. Oh, there she is. Sri Devi, you have something to say?
Yeah. Since we are on this topic, I just want to humbly submit that today I'll be doing a talk show with Tade Prabhu. It's called Mental and Emotional Health and Its Impact on Relationships. And it's on Facebook Live, 8 p.m. Europe time. I don't know what time that will be in U.S., maybe 1 o'clock or something. You'll have to check and see whether whatever it is. But a lot of people are asking a lot of questions, and you know, we're as devotees, we're trying to do our best to help. So if anyone is particularly interested, they're welcome to join. And I just wanted to share that.
How can they join?
Oh, Guru Maharaj, I can send you the link. Oh, maybe I should post it in the chat so that.
Yes, you know, please.
It's okay.
And will it be on your Facebook page, Sridevi?
Yeah, it's on my Facebook page.
I thought so. Okay.
And it's also on Tade Prabhu's Facebook page. Tade, what I will do is I'll give you his name. Tade, he's very popular, and he does this talk show. He calls it the Tadek Show. So that's his name. And maybe I will send you the Facebook link so that you can see it over there. Is that a good idea?
Yes, Sridevi, go ahead. Absolutely.
Okay, let me just search that and put it in the chat. But anybody can just join in, and if you want the Zoom link. No, I think the Zoom link is just for the host and me, but it's live on Facebook, and I can send you the link.
Sounds good. Perfect.
That's tonight. So tonight, 8 p.m. at CET, right?
8 p.m. Europe time, Guru Maharaj, whatever that is called, I don't know.
Yeah, Central European time, CET. Mm-hmm.
So would it be like around 1-ish in America, Maharaj?
Yeah, well, in the East Coast, it would be 2. No, the East Coast, it would be 2 o'clock p.m. And then you go to, Central time, it's 1 hour earlier, like that. Yeah, so it's 2 o'clock your time.
Okay, thank you, Maharaj. Maharaj, would you like to end with 1 hour chanting, or was it too late for you? We bombarded with a lot of questions today.
I have to say yes to both questions. It is too late, and I would also like to end with some japa. So
yes, Maharaj, it's your call, Maharaj. Whatever you say is fine. We're at your service.
Well, I go get my beads. I'll be right back.
Yes, Maharaj. Thank you. This is what happens, but when we have Maharaj and then we just go on and on. And get all the nectar. Sridevi, did you move to Europe, or you're visiting Europe?
I'm just visiting Europe. I'm transiting from here to Mayapur. Guru Maharaj wanted me to come here and do some seva, so that's how I'm here.
You're fortunate. Very nice.
Yes, I'm extremely fortunate. I have the most wonderful Guru Maharaj in the whole universe.
Yes, I can 150% vouch on that.
We are also blessed. We are also blessed by Maharaj. Absolutely. Without a shadow of a doubt.
Absolutely.
Krishna Mataji, Sridevi Mataji, are you posting the link on the God Family group as well?
Do you want me to? I was a little hesitant because I don't want my God family to think here she is tooting her own horn.
No, it's not tooting at all, Sridevi. It's literally sharing. I think you should do that.
Even I think you should do that because it might help a lot of people.
Oh, okay. All right. If you, my God sister, asked me to do it, now I feel courageous enough to do it.
Please, you should do it.
I will. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Jai Shri Krishna, Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasavi, Gaur Bhaktivinoda. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Sri Devi, shut off your microphone.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama 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 Hari Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari Rama Hari Rama Rama Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Krishna Hari Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama Rama Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari 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 Krishna Hari Krishna 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 Hari Hari Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna. Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare. Jai Sri Krishna, Chaitanya, Prabhu, Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasati, Gaur Bhaktivinam, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Thank you all for your participation and your association. We look forward to the next opportunity.
Thank you so much, Maharaj, for always giving us your endless time to answer our questions and to give us your darshan. And we always look forward to having you on. And we thank all the devotees for joining us. Vantra Krafti Vyascha, Kripa Sindhu Bevacha, Patita Nampa Vinebhyo, Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha, Shila Prabhupada Ki Jai, His Holiness Candramauli Swami Ki Jai. Have a wonderful day, devotees. Hare Krishna.